Alright, so I got 6 Bulbasaur planters here. Some are pretty rough. And it's all PLA. And I'm going to go through and try different ways of smoothing out the PLA. And we'll see which one works out best. Smooth out your prints to get rid of these ridges, any sort of layer separation, anything like that. We're going to smooth them up so that when we put some finishing paint on them, it's going to be nice and glossy. And we got a couple different things we're going to try out here. We're going to do these. The other one's there for comparison when we're all done. We're going to do some Rust-Oleum protective enamel, triple thick glaze, some appliance epoxy, and then finally, and this one's going to be a little bit rougher, it's the finishing resin. And that's probably a little bit overkill for most projects. It's a little bit more difficult to apply, but it's definitely going to give you a rock solid. It's going to be able to take quite a bit of a beating. So these two are obviously going to be quite easy to apply. First thing you're going to want to do is make sure you have a proper work area, something behind your project. You want to put on some nice nitrile latex, and then you want to make sure you're in a well ventilated area, because this stuff is really toxic. These triple thick glaze, so like I said, doing the aerosol is the easiest part. Just get into a well ventilated area, and then here I've got the appliance epoxy. Looks like it's got definitely a less glossy finish.
Okay, so I got the easy aerosols done, and now I'm gonna move on to the Rust-Oleum. Oh geez, yeah, there you can kind of see it. Just remember, always be in a ventilated area, you know, or maybe use a mask. You want a little bit thick, that's why you're using a brush. I'm using a sponge instead of a brush.
On. All right, now the epoxy is going to be a little bit harder. You're going to have two chemicals you're going to have to mix. It has to be on a pretty warm environment. It's got to be like 75, 80 degrees is the best. A wood stove here, nice and warm. So if you want to do it in a well-ventilated area. The mixture doesn't need to be completely exact. Some people measure it. I just eyeball it, and I've never really had any problems using it. And you mix it up real good. And the warmer the better, really. 90 degrees even. Make sure everything gets mixed up really well. And make sure you wear gloves too, because this stuff is nasty. You don't want to be getting it on your hands. It's an irritant for the skin, eyes, everything. So you just want to really try and avoid getting that anywhere. And then especially if it's warm, you want to make sure you do this relatively quickly. Apply it liberally. It'll get tacky, so it's pretty easy to layer it on there nice and thick. We'll see how this one turns out. Alright, so here's the final breakdown. Got all of them here. I even added one, this Flex Seal Clear. It's like a water sealant, like rubber spray on stuff. This stuff definitely seemed like it was pretty thick. It's not quite as glossy. And it even has some like areas where it kind of foamed up a little tiny bit. Like it's got some little miniature bubbles there. Definitely probably too small to see on the camera. I'm going to paint all these different colors so we can have a final look. This one, as you can see there, some of the cracks just didn't quite seal up. I even gave this one an extra 4th coat. Yeah, it didn't quite seal up very well. Kind of did on the forehead there. Thick glaze, I think, worked the best here. Alright, here we have the final process, which is going to be painting. That one at the end is the baseline. That's before I did anything to it. This one is the epoxy. Definitely has the most shine to it. This one doesn't really have as much shine. That's the protective enamel. I put 2 coats on that one. and it did pretty well, but you still get a little bit of that layering. This one definitely a lot smoother. Come down to the triple thick glaze enamel. This worked out pretty good. A little bit of ridges, but definitely a lot better job than this oil-based primer. And we got the flex seal. Not quite as glossy. It seemed to smooth things up, but just didn't really quite perform as well as I thought it would. And this one did okay. It's the appliance epoxy. It was definitely pretty thick laying on there, and it took a little bit longer to dry than some of the other stuff, but didn't quite do as well as the triple thick glaze. I think is one of the better. The epoxy finishing resin definitely did the best, and I only put one layer on with that. If you put two or three layers, it would be incredibly smooth, but otherwise I think the triple thick glaze did quite well. And the protective enamel probably would have done better if I would have put three or four coats. Now I'm gonna do paint on all these and we can see which one looks the best. And I'll give a final vote here too in the details. And I'll rate them on a few different things. Alright, so here is everything all complete. I put about two layers of paint on each one of these. And we have this one here, which was nothing. There was no preparation done to this one. It's just printed out and then painted. We got this one here, the epoxy. You know, it looked a lot smoother before I painted it, and some of these lines really came out. So I think maybe two or three layers on that one, and it would have turned out a lot better. With the appliance epoxy, as you can see, it didn't turn out too well. Only slightly better than if I wouldn't have done anything at all. Protective enamel. And that one worked okay. Two layers. I'd say if you did three or four, that one would probably do a little bit better. Still not as good as you'd like to see. The triple thick glaze. I did a little bit different paint job with this one. And it turned out pretty good. Not quite as good as I thought it was going to. And then of course down here we have the flex seal. Which, you know, this one turned out okay. You can't really see it in the camera because it's not that high quality, but it's got little tiny itty bitty bubbles in it. And I'll take some detail shots and upload those. So, all in all, I would say that probably the best, after seeing the paint job, really was the triple thick glaze or the Z epoxy, even though it didn't turn out as good as it looked before. And the protective enamel, the oil based, that one did quite well. And I think just to cap them all off, I'm going to throw the triple thick glaze over everything just to make them real nice and shiny. And I'll get a final shot of that.
Alright, here they all are.
Finalized with their
coat.
And,
they actually look a lot better once you get the gloss back on them. I think because some of those paints were a little bit
more,
took away some of that shine. So yeah, that's my breakdown, and thanks for watching.
Put two or three coats on there for good measure.